Acer has finally launched its economic flagship series of Predator Helios 300 in India. And I know 110,000 is nowhere near to economic, but you guys have no idea at what price everyone is getting it. So if you want to get this beast at 50% of what it costs, stick with us till the end. Before starting, let me tell you that if you want to get the real taste of the video, make sure that you watch the video on at least 480p video quality so that the video looks crispy and clear. And till then, enjoy the chorus. So before starting, there are two things you should know. Firstly, this video is not sponsored by Acer or any third party company in any way. And secondly, this is an Indian variant of the Predator Helios 300, which means we are going to have something less than the international variant. And unfortunately, this time around, it is a GPU. Yes, we don't get a GTX 1060, but we get a 1050 Ti. I know this is a deal breaker for most of the people, but make sure that you watch the whole video before you come to this verdict. Starting from the physical overview, top of the laptop is a metal plate with brushed aluminium texture and Predator logo on it. The chassis flex is almost negligible and hinges are made well too. If we compare it to the price we get it at, it is definitely excellent quality. It's not really lightweight, but it isn't too heavy as well. It weighs around 2.5 kg, which is perfectly normal as it is a budget gaming laptop. Now coming to the technical specifications of this laptop, we get a Kaby Lake 7700HQ. In an easy language, it is the 7th generation Core i7 clocked at 2.8 GHz. GPU, as I've already told you, is unfortunately the 4GB GTX 1050 Ti. We get a 1080p LCD panel which has above average viewing angles and kinda average color accuracy. We also get 8GB of DDR4 RAM, which of course is upgradable. We get a 128GB SSD and 1TB hard drive. Windows 10 comes pre-installed on the SSD, which results in a super fast boot up time. The trackpad on this thing uses Windows Precision drivers, which is very accurate, and the clicks need a bit of force to be used. We get two down firing speakers which are kinda average and are kinda usable while gaming because the fans aren't too loud, although they lack bass and accuracy, so if I were you, I'd use headphones. The camera on this thing is a 720p shooter. In case you want to know how it looks like, this is how it looks like. And as per me, this is a decent camera for a gaming laptop. And that too at this price point. The port selection is pretty standard, but if compared with price, it is excellent. We get 3 USB A's, one Type-C, which unfortunately isn't Thunderbolt, and rest of the ports are HDMI, Ethernet, and 3.5mm headphone jack. Now coming to the main highlight of the laptop, that is gaming. You can play all the modern games on this laptop, but most of the high-end games will give you some amount of frame drop or a frame freeze. But that isn't a deal breaker, because Acer provides you inbuilt applications to crank up the fan to the max settings to reduce heating, which actually results in a smooth lagless game performance, but it won't work on every game, because some games will demand too much power, and 1050 Ti isn't just made for that. If compared to the price of ₹60,000, this laptop has no cons. But I want you all to know what you are purchasing. So here are the things that I don't like about this laptop. Number 1. The brightness of the screen is not my cup of tea. No, it's not very less, but it's not very bright as well. It's this low that when you're working outdoors in bright sun, it'll be hard to work. Even when the brightness is cranked up to the highest level. Not only that, but the display isn't a good color producer as well. The color accuracy is kinda mediocre on this laptop, or I'd say below average. But a normal human like you or me won't be able to spot much of a difference, but still, I don't like the display. Number 2 is the battery backup. We get a 48 watt hour battery that is not bad at the price we're getting it, but yet it's not good. You will get about 4 to 5 hours of screen on time on normal usage and about 3 hours of screen on time on heavy gaming. Although the battery backup for casual usage is not good, but I'd still consider it to be above average as far as the price is concerned. So the verdict is that for a price of ₹60,000 to ₹75,000, this laptop is a must grab deal. And also, for the most part, I understand the fact that this GPU is not the best for 1080p gaming, but by cranking the fans to the max settings and getting a headphone on your ears, you can get amazing gaming performance on lower thermal temperatures. Moreover, you have two upgrade options, so in case you find the 8GB RAM slowing you down, keep in mind that one slot is always available to upgrade. Now coming to the topic of price, this laptop costs 1,10,000, but Diwali sale is up. Prices will drop a lot, so make sure to keep an eye on this laptop. We'll drop down links in the description, so make sure that you keep checking the links, cause this laptop is a must grab deal for the price anywhere near 60,000 to 75,000. If you liked the video, hit the like button, comment down, and also make sure to hit the red subscribe button and the notification bell icon to receive such great quality content in near future. Thank you for watching. Peace.